So here we group numbers, okay?
According to Mulinde Apollo, the Kamwenge District Education Officer, a total of 4,847 candidates are set to sit for their primary living examinations in the district.
Our candidates for 2022, and this year we have 4,847 who will be sitting their PLE next week. Today, Wednesday, we are receiving the district monitor at any time. He has not arrived, we are called, but we are in touch.
Mulinde says government has come out with tough rules, including termination of teachers' academic credentials once implicated in examination malpractice. He has urged schools to follow the standard operating procedures in the fight against Ebola spread. He also urged schools to allow students that have not completed their school fees to sit for their final papers.
If a teacher is implicated for participating in examination malpractice, the teacher will be suspended from service. In fact, it's not even suspension, but it's dismissal from service in addition to the registration of the teacher. So if the teacher is registered, then he's registered automatically. And if a teacher is only a teacher after he or she has registered, in the moment you are registered, you remain with your papers, but you cannot be called a teacher since if you are not registered by the Ministry of Education.
The message I'm giving to my fellow teachers is that they should let learners sit for exams on their own. They should not get biased on how the learners will perform. Because if they have given these learners what is required, then learners will pass.
Ntewa Mualifa, the head teacher at Birambi Primary School, says the guidelines will help them have a successful primary living examination period.
Concerning the prevention of Ebola, as a school, we have enough handing washing facilities which we are going to use. Even now we are using them. We have liquid soap, we have hand washing soap, so we are using water enough to wash our hands time to time, frequently. Our children are using those handing washing facilities to wash their hands and ensure they are scattered, they are not congested. In one place. We are trying even to give them more light on how to prevent Ebola.
The first sanitize and enters. And these officials should also put on face masks. We have emphasized that one. All our examination centers, we observe SOPs. And during our monitoring as a department, as the office of the chief administrative officer, still we shall ensure all examination centers observe SOPs. Because we expect so many visitors from within and outside the district.
The primary living examinations will start on Tuesday next week. Parents and teachers have been urged to prepare candidates for their final examinations. Report compiled by Anthony Atwini for the news.